God, I saw a channel and I saw Wormcloak and I thought GG noob, but unfortunately, the reality is it's not an Emrakul. Scalding Tarn from the opponent. Emrakul. Or Mox so we can cast turn 2 Harmonize this game. Would make up for the feel bads last game. Forest is not the enemy. Why would he say forest is the enemy? We need these trees. Ship the turn. There's a decent chance the opponent has removal on this turn or the next turn or the next turn before we hit 4 mana, so hopefully the opponent's just got nothing going on. No bagel, no bagel, no bagel, no bagel, no bagel. Sylvan Caryatid is acceptable. Skull Clamp. Now there is a predicament. As bad as I want to cash it in right now before the opponent can remove it, I do want to cast Harmonize next turn. I am going to clamp it off. It's really greedy, but the opponent has shown us removal. So I made the incredibly greedy play. And the thing is, the sooner we hit Wyrmcloak, the better, too. So, or the sooner we hit Emrakul, the better. With the cards we drew, that was pretty loose, but. And it was a pretty loose play, but if we had seen Emrakul, it would have been like, oh, duh, yeah, that's why I did that. I'm genius. Also, the opponent still might have the Diabolic Edict. We don't know. They don't. Is this a Jace? Jace the Mind Sculptor. Not a problem last game. Looks at the top of our deck. Leaves it on top. It's not Emrakul. Borosignet. Sweet, actually. So, we could play Channel, but again, just want to save that until it's high time. Wanted to play that real fast so the opponent knew that giving us Borosignet was dumb, too. Not dumb, but it seemed like a good draw. I mean, I was happy to see that it was there. I guess the opponent has no idea what the contents of our hand is. We clamped away mana that we needed, so the opponent left mana that they think we don't need. So that was smart. By us or by them? Who knows? Alright, meanwhile, Vampire Nighthawk coming down and Bitter Blossom. So we do need to be concerned about opposition. That could be a thing. I'm gonna cast the Harmonize because we're getting towards an Emrakul or bust type scenario. As we're way behind. But there's survival, so next turn I believe we can channel Emrakul. I'm not sure if we have. We should have the life and the mana to do it. Unfortunately, not the mana to play a leftover Wyrmcloak, but maybe to play a leftover Gilded Lotus. I believe so, actually. Again, it depends what the opponent. Oh no, we won't. Okay. Again, it all depends. Is the opponent going to discard or play a counterspell or play another Void? A lot can go wrong on this turn. Play an opposition. Probably whatever we're hoping to do is not going to go through on this turn. So, sorry to be a buzzkill, but I don't expect to get there, to be honest, with what we're facing. But who knows? Maybe the opponent has totally nothing. We can operate through a Diabolic Edict, so maybe they play that. Or maybe we just draw the Emrakul too. Things can still go our way. Mana is tapping. Bone Shredder. That is not a problem. I mean, if the opponent leaves up Diabolic Edict to mana, then. We might lose to it. I believe that's what's happening. Oh, Demonic Shooter. Okay, that's interesting. Demonic Shooter, tap out for it. So it's for something for next turn. Little does the opponent know that we have Emrakul yet again. Every game. GG, noob. I need to stop saying that, but it's just funny to say. It's a little bit of trash talk. I think trash talk's all right. We can pay 17 life to play a Gilded Lotus with 12 mana, and then tap for an Emrakul, and then take an extra turn, and then cast a Crater Hoof. There's a Mox, so that helps too. Tap this mana, play a Survival. Do we not have enough green? No, we have enough green. The Mox made it. We didn't have enough green. No, we have enough green. That changed nothing. We have a spare colorless either way. All right, discard a Pelucranus. Wait, was that the winning card? Grab an Emrakul. I'm always paranoid. Channel. So we can pay 17 life. We can play Gilded Lotus off to 13. Yeah, and then that will allow us to play Crater Hoof on the following turn for the I win. Yeah, this is Channel Emrakul's the classic Raffle Stomp combo. Oh god, I clicked it once too many and we have a floating mana. So I clicked it once more, we could have died. I don't think you can undo. I guess we should equip with Skullclamp with our spare mana. All right, my turn again. It's times like these that I hope the opponent says something hateful in the chat, like Eureka. I'm not gonna play Eureka. I will play Crater Hoof though. Crater Hoof Behemoth. We have the mana to survival and then play Crater Hoof. Attack you. Attack you. So good games. Great games. I'm sorry. Thanks for playing. Good luck in the next one. I'm trying to do this with good etiquette, so that my handshake doesn't get denied. I might even lose. Is it possible that we lose? I don't want to look like the asshole. Excuse my language. I can say asshole on these. Oh, I don't want to be the asshole who is a bad winner, and then the opponent browns them out with a Slaughter Pact, and then I just don't think there's any combination of cards that could save them, so. So we'll see what the opponent, if the opponent's there. The opponent's definitely there. I feel like they're thinking about saying something. Well, we'll return shortly. All right, we're back. The opponent actually thought about what to sacrifice. It's like, yo, listen, we have trample. Does the opponent have Slaughter Pact? No, but that doesn't make a difference. What's happening? Does the opponent have something? I hear an alternate cost. No, it's declaring blockers. I was hearing things. Okay. Well, see you guys in round three as we try to win back-to-backs.